Hello dear students, myself Miss Vaishali Dekate. Welcome to my channel. I am teaching you subject maths in standard 8. In this video, we will start chapter number 5, expansion formulae. We will solve questions from practice set 5.1. But before that, subscribe my channel by pressing subscribe at right side. Press the bell icon also to get my all videos of 8th standard. First, let us recall these algebraic formulae which we have learnt in our previous standards. These are known as expansion formulae also. So, first formula which we have learnt is a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now, second formula which we had learned is a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. And third expansion formula is a plus b and a minus b second bracket is equal to a square minus b square. So these three formulae are basic expansion formulae or basic algebraic formulae which we all have to remember all the time. Now let us see this new formula which is introduced this year in 8th standard. What is the formula? X plus a in first bracket, x minus b in second bracket is equal to, its expansion is x square plus bracket a plus b into x plus AB means A multiplied by B, A into B. So, if you observe these two brackets carefully, you can see that in both the brackets, first term is same. XX. So, when we expand these two brackets or when we use the formula, how to write this first term square? Okay, both the bracket is having same term, first term. So, first term square plus inside bracket, what is there? Addition of second terms. A plus B. Both terms are having plus sign. So, it should be written with plus sign. If they are having minus sign, so inside the bracket, we have to write with minus sign. And then multiply by X. Again, multiply by this first term. Then plus sign is there. And there is multiplication of second terms. That is A multiply by B. AB means A multiply by B. So, there are three terms. When we expand these two brackets, there are three terms. First term is the square of first term in both the brackets. Second term is a plus b into x. And third term is a multiplied by b. So, in this way, when two brackets are there, there is multiplication of two brackets. In both the brackets, binomials are there. Binomial means two terms. We all know binomials are there. And in binomials, if the first term is same and second term can be any term, so we can apply this formula to solve the sum. So we will be solving the sums from practice set 5.1 based on this formula. Let us see how to solve. Now let's start practice set 5.1. Practice set 5.1 question is expand. When this question is like expand, we have to expand by using formula. As we have learned the formula just now, we will be using the formula for expansion of all these sums. As you all can see, in all these sums, there are two brackets and inside the brackets, there are binomial. That means two terms are there. And in all these brackets, first term is same. If you observe it carefully, you can see that first terms are same and second terms are different. So we can use our formula. Just now we have learned the formula. But the other method for solving this type of sum is also there. I will be showing you that other method also. But as expand is there, so in 8th standard we will be using formula to solve the sum. So I will be showing you other method first and then we will solve by formula. So first sum, a plus 2 and a plus 1. A plus 2 and a minus 1 can be solved. This is method 1. Okay. So, how to solve this? This can be solved. First term of first bracket multiply by second bracket, full second bracket, a minus 1. Then, second term of first bracket multiply by second bracket again. What is second term? Second term is plus 2. So, we will be writing second term with sign. If it is plus 2, write plus 2. If it is minus 2, write minus 2. That means whichever sign is there in the first bracket, we write with that sine and then multiply by second bracket again. So first term of first bracket multiply by second bracket, then plus sign is there, so write plus sign plus second term of first bracket multiply by second bracket again. Now multiply, a into a is a square. Now minus sign is there, put the minus sign. A into minus 1 is minus a. We have multiplied both the terms by a. Now multiply both the terms by 2. Plus 2 into a is plus 2a. Plus minus will become minus 2 ones are 2. Okay, 2 into a is 2a and 2 ones are 2. In this way we have multiplied. Now next step, this first term and last term, a square and 2, we cannot do anything. So first term as it is we write, but middle two terms, as you all can see, both the terms are a terms. So this is minus 1a plus 2a. That means what? 2a minus 1a. What is 2a minus 1a? 2a minus 1a will be 1a. But when 1 is there, we don't write it. We write only a. So it will be plus a. And this minus 2 last term we write as it is. So in this way we have got the answer as a square plus a minus 2. All these three terms are different terms. They are not like terms. So they cannot be added. They cannot be subtracted. So this is our answer. This is the expansion of these two brackets. So this is the simple method by which we can solve these two brackets. But in this particular practice set or this year in standard 8, we will be applying the formula to solve this sum. So now I will be showing you the method which we are going to continue to solve all the sums from practice set 5.1. So this method also valid method which you can apply, but now we will be solving by the method of formula. So here we write by using formula. So we will use formula. Formula is x plus a x plus b in second bracket is equal to x square plus in bracket a plus b multiply by x plus a into b. A b means a multiply by b. Now let us write our question and apply the formula. Question is a plus 2 a minus 1. A plus 2 a minus 1 is equal to. See children, if you observe the question and formula carefully and compare it, what we can see that first terms are same. Here in formula first term is x, in our question first term is a. Okay, now second term in formula is a, here plus 2, here plus b, and here minus 1. So a means 2, b means minus 1, and x is a in our question. So in place of x we will be writing a, in place of a we will be writing plus 2, in place of b we will be writing minus 1. So in this way we will apply the formula. So x square means first term square. First term in the question is a square plus in bracket a plus b. Our a is 2. If you see here carefully, a is 2, b is minus 1. So plus 2 minus 1 multiply by x. X is a in the question plus a into b. A is 2 plus 2 into multiply by b is minus 1. Okay, here a into b both are alphabet, both are variables, so multiplication sign is not given. But as we have given the numbers, we have to write this multiplication sign. If you write 2 minus 1, it will be having different meaning. Okay, now let us solve this. In this way we have got three terms. Now this is one term, this is second term, this is third term. Terms are separated by plus or minus sign. Okay, always see that terms are separated by plus sign, they are not separated by multiply sign. So three terms we can see here. First term is a square. Now see children, 2 minus 1. What is 2 minus 1? It will be 1. And 1 into a is 1a. But mostly we don't write this 1. We only write a. We don't write coefficient 1. When 1 is the coefficient, we don't write. we only write a plus a. Now, so when in addition or subtraction, we always write the sign of bigger number. 2 minus 1, sign of bigger number is plus, and so that we have got plus 1 as the answer, correct? In subtraction or addition, 2 minus 1. We always write the sign of bigger number and then write the answer. Sign of bigger number is plus and 2 minus 1 is 1. So in this way we have got plus 1 here. But 1 is the coefficient, we don't write it. Okay. Now here multiplication is there. So in multiplication, plus into minus is equal to minus. Correct. Minus into plus is also equal to minus. Plus into plus is equal to plus. And minus into minus is also equal to plus. We all know this. These are the rules of multiplication. And in addition, always give the sign of bigger number. These two things you always have to remember so that there will not be any confusion and there will not be any mistake. So plus minus will become minus, but sign of bigger number. And multiplication, plus into minus, sign is minus, 2 ones are 2. In this way, we get the same answer, a square plus a minus 2, as we have got by this method, multiplication. So in method 1 also, we have got a square plus a minus 2. Here also, we have got a square plus a minus 2. So we will be using formula to solve our sums. Now let us see the second sum. Second sum is m minus 4 m plus 6. M minus 4 in first bracket, m plus 6 in the second bracket. Again we start our sum by using formula. Write the formula. Every time you should write the formula. So it will be by-hearted automatically. You don't require any efforts to by-heart the formula. If you write every time, it will be by-hearted automatically. So x plus a, x plus b in first bracket is equal to x square plus in bracket a plus b into x plus a into b. A b means a into b. Now write the question. M minus 4 m plus 6 is equal to. Now, our x means m. From formula, x is there, but in question, first term is m. Now, a means minus 4. A is minus 4 and b is plus 6. So, in place of x, we will be writing m. In place of a, we will be writing minus 4. In place of b, we will be writing 6. So, write m square plus a plus b. So, it is minus 4 plus 6. Minus 4 plus 6. Into x, x is m, plus a into b, that is minus 4 into 6. Now solve this. First term we write as it is m square. Plus minus will become minus, but sign of bigger number. Bigger number is 6, so sign is plus. 6 minus 4 is 2, and this m, 2m. Now in multiplication, plus into minus will be minus. Plus minus minus, sign is minus. 6 4s are 24. In this way, all the three terms are different. We cannot add them, we cannot subtract them. So this is the answer. Now let us see the third sum. Third sum is p plus 8, p minus 3. P plus 8, p minus 3. Again, we start our solution by using formula. Formula is x plus a into x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. Now write the question. पी प्लस एट पी माइनस थ्री इज इक्वल टू. नाउ एक्स इज पी, फर्स्ट टर्म इज पी, ए इज प्लस एट, बी इज सॉरी प्लस बी शुड बी देयर, हियर प्लस बी शुड बी देयर, ओके, बी इज माइनस थ्री. Now let us solve. In place of x we will be writing p, in place of a we will be writing plus 8, in place of b we will be writing minus 3. So m square means p square plus 8 minus 3 into p plus 8 multiply by minus 3. P square, in addition sign of bigger number. 8 is having plus sign, so here answer also should have plus sign. Now 8 minus 3 is 5, this p is 5p. Now in multiplication plus into minus is minus, 8 3 is 24. So answer is p square plus 5p minus 24. Fourth sum, 13 plus x, 13 minus x. 13 plus x and 13 minus x. See children, if you observe this sum carefully, what you can see, binomials are there, that means two terms are there and both the terms are same, only the difference is of sign. First term is 13 in first bracket, second term is x in first bracket, in second bracket also first term is 13, second term is x, only the difference is of sign. Here in the first bracket sign is plus, in the second bracket sign is minus. So in such cases we can solve this sum by applying the other formula, that means we can apply x plus a x minus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a b. This formula also we can apply, or we can apply this third formula which we have learned before in our previous standard. That means third formula is a plus b in first bracket, a minus b in second bracket is equal to a square minus b square. Why we can apply this formula? Because in this formula we can see that both the terms are same in both the brackets. Only the difference is of sign. In first bracket there is plus sign, in the second bracket there is minus sign. So as in our sum also we have got same terms in both the brackets, only difference is sign. Here in the formula also same terms in both the bracket, only the difference is of sign. So we can apply this formula also and this formula also. I will be showing you both the formulas, application of both the formulae. So first I will be applying this formula a plus b into a minus b, and then we will apply our regular formula. Okay, so first formula, method 1. By using formula a plus b a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. So our question is 13 plus x 13 minus x is equal to, now first term square minus second term square, very easy. That means 13 square minus x square. 13 is first term in both the terms, in both the brackets. X is second term in both the brackets. So 13 square is 169. X square we cannot do anything. So it is x square only. So 169 minus x square, both the terms are different terms. We cannot do anything. This is our answer. Okay. Now let us see by application of our formula which we have applied in previous three sums. Method 2. Okay. Method 2 is, again we will be applying formula, by using formula x plus a x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. Now write the question. Question is 13 plus x and 13 minus x. Now as we all can observe here, x is 13, a is plus x and b is minus x. So let us apply now. X square means 13 square plus a is plus x, b is minus x into x means 13 now plus a is plus x multiplied by b is minus x. Okay, now solve. 13 square is 169 plus x into x is 0. 0 into 13 will also be 0. This answer of this middle term is 0. X minus x is 0, as 1 minus 1 is 0, 5 minus 5 is 0, 100 minus 100 is 0. Similarly, x minus x is also 0. 0 into 13 will be 0 again. 0 multiplied by any number, answer is 0. Now, plus minus minus. X into x is x square. As middle term is 0, we will not write it. We will be writing the first term and last term only. 169 minus x square. So, see, the answer is same in by applying both formula. So, I think application of this formula becomes very easy for this particular sum. You can apply any one method for solving this sum. Now, fifth sum is 3x plus 4y, 3x plus 5y. First terms are same, but second term are not same. So, we will be applying our regular formula now. 3x plus 4y, 3x plus 5y. By using formula, I will be writing again. By using formula, x plus a first bracket, x plus b in the second bracket, x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. Okay, now apply the formula, write the sums. 3x plus 4y, 3x plus 5y. Now, our first term is 3x. So, we should write 3x square. Now, with variable, there is coefficient also. We will put in the bracket. Only coefficient, only variable is there. So, we don't put in the bracket. Only coefficient is there. That means only constant number is there. We don't put in the bracket. But both are there. Coefficient as well as variable put inside the bracket. And afterwards, solve it in the next step. Plus, a plus b. A is 4y. A is 4y if you see here, and b is 5y. So 4y plus 5y into x. Our x is not only x, it is 3x. First term is 3x multiply by 3x, we can write, plus a into b. A is 4y multiply by b is 5y. So in this way, first apply the formula properly and then only solve the sum. So, here we have got these three terms. This is first term, this is second term, this is third term. Terms are separated by plus or minus sign. They are not separated by multiplication sign. Always keep this in mind. So, 3x square. We have to write the square of 3 also. 3 square is 9. 3 square is 9 and square of x is x square. Now, plus plus. All signs are plus. So, we will write plus here. 4y plus 5y is 9y into 3x is there. So, we write into 3x. Okay. This is again one term. Again, we can solve it afterwards. Now, plus plus signs are there. So, we will write plus sign. 4 5s are 20 and y into y is y square. Now, this middle term can be solved again. First term we have to write as it is 9x square. This term can be solved. 9 3s are 27 y into x is xy plus 20y square. Now, all three terms are different terms. They are not like terms. They cannot be added again. So, this is our answer. Now, let us see. This was our fifth sum. Now, let us see the sixth sum. 9x minus 5t, 9x plus 3t. 9x minus 5t, 9x plus 3t. Now, we will be writing formula. By using formula, formula is x plus a in first bracket, x plus b in second bracket is equal to x square plus in bracket a plus b into x plus a into b. Now let us apply the formula to the sum 9x minus 5t and 9x plus 3t is equal to first term square. First term is x. Here first term is 9x. So we have to write 9x square. But coefficient and variable both are there, so we will put inside the bracket and then we write square. Plus a plus b. A is 5t. If you see here, a is minus 5t and b is plus 3t. So we write with the sign minus 5t plus 3t into multiply sign. We write only x is there. X is first term in the formula. In our sum, first term is 9x. Plus a into b. A is minus 5t into b. B is 3t. Multiply by 3t. Now solve this. 9x square. We can solve 9 square also. We can write 9 square also. It is 81. And square of x is x square. Now see children. Minus plus will become minus, but we have to write the sign of bigger number. Bigger number is 5, so write the sign of bigger number, minus. Minus plus will become minus. 5t minus 3t is 2t. Multiply by this 9x. Now plus minus will become minus sign. In multiplication, plus minus sign is minus. In addition, we write the sign of bigger number. Always keep this in mind. 5 threes are 15 and t into t is t square. Now middle term can be multiplied, so we will multiply the middle term. 81x square minus 9 to the 18, t into x will be tx, plus, sorry, not plus, it is minus. Minus sign is there, so we write minus sign. Minus 15t square. All the terms are different terms. We cannot subtract them. So this is our answer. Seven sum. M plus 2 upon 3. M minus 7 upon 3. So let us solve by using formula. Write the formula. X plus a in first bracket, x plus b in the second bracket is equal to x square plus in bracket a plus b into x plus a into b. Now apply the formula. We will be writing our sum m plus 2 upon 3 and m minus 7 upon 3. So x is m here, a is plus 2 upon 3. And b is minus 7 upon 3. Correct? So now let us apply the formula here. X square means m square, first term square, plus inside bracket we will be writing addition of a plus b. A is plus 2 upon 3. B is minus 7 upon 3. So 2 upon 3 minus 7 upon 3 into x. X means m here in our sum. X is m. So write m, x is m, x means the first term is m, plus a into b, a is 2 upon 3, into b is minus 7 upon 3, m square. Now see children, 2 upon 3 minus 7 upon 3, how to solve this? 2 upon 3 minus 7 upon 3. Both the numbers fractions are there, and both the fractions are having same denominator, so denominator common is there. We write common denominator one time, and whatever there in the numerator we do that. So it is 2 minus 7, like this, 2 minus 7, and denominator common we have written one time. Now 2 minus 7 plus minus will become minus sign of bigger number. Bigger number is 7, so we write sign of bigger number. So 2 minus 7 is 5 upon 3. It will be minus 5 upon 3. So here we'll write minus 5 upon 3 into m. Now plus minus multiplication is there. So in multiplication, plus minus sign is minus. Now in multiplication, what we do? We multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. When addition subtraction is there, what we do? If common denominator is there, we write one time denominator and we add or subtract in the numerator. But in multiplication, what we do? We multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. 2 sevens are 14 and 3 threes are 9. In this way, we have to solve. And now, as you all can see, all these three terms are different terms. We cannot subtract them, we cannot add them. So, this is our answer. Now, next term is x plus 1 upon x, x minus 1 upon x. Both terms in both the brackets are same. First term is x, first term is x. Second term is 1 upon x, second term is 1 upon x. The difference is of sign. In first bracket there is plus sign, in second bracket there is minus sign. It is like the fourth sum. In fourth sum we have applied both the formulae. I have shown you by applying both the formulae. But here we will not apply both the formulae. We will apply single one formula, which is a plus b, a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. So we should make our questions and solutions very easy. So let us write the question first. Eighth question is, first bracket x plus 1 upon x, second bracket x minus 1 upon x. So as I have told you, we will apply only the formula which we have learned before by using formula a plus b, a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. Both terms are same in both the brackets. Binomials are same, only difference is of sign, plus minus sign. So we will be applying this formula. Now let us write x plus 1 upon x, x minus 1 upon x is equal to first term square, first term is x, x square minus b square, b is second term, second term is square, second term is 1 upon x square. So x square minus 1 square is 1 upon x square is x square. In this way we get the answer. So always make the sum easy, don't make it complicated. Now let us see the last sum, ninth one. 1 upon y plus 4, 1 upon y minus 4. Now, 1 upon y plus 4, 1 upon y minus 9 is there. Now, second terms are different, so we will have to apply the formula by using formula. Now, we cannot apply this formula here. In this formula, both the terms should be same. But here, the second terms are different, so we have to apply the formula of x plus a and x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. Now apply the formula. Our sum is 1 upon y plus 4, 1 upon y minus 9. First term square, first term is 1 upon y. In both the brackets, first term is 1 upon y. So 1 upon y square, I will put inside the bracket and then I will write the square, plus a plus b, a is plus 4, b is, here plus we should write in formula, there is plus sign. Now our b is minus 9, so we should write plus 4 minus 9 into first term is x, here first term is 1 upon y, into 1 upon y, plus a into b, a is plus 4 into b is minus 9. Now solve. 1 square is 1 upon y square is y square. Now in addition, we always write the sign of bigger number, which is minus. Now plus minus will become minus. 9 minus 4 is 5 into 1 upon y. In multiplication, plus into minus will become minus. 9 fours are 36. Okay, now 1 upon y square, 5 into 1 is 5 upon y minus 36. In this way, we can solve all the sums. Thank you for watching my video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.